Hi, welcome to the Petersen Museum. My name is Andrew Chatham. I'm a director of engineering at Waymo, and I'm excited to talk to you about a new exhibit at the museum on Waymo's road to creating the world's most experienced driver. You may have seen cars like this driving around Los Angeles with nobody behind the wheel. That's what we've been working on. And first, I'd like to take you back to how the project began. People have been dreaming about autonomous driving almost since we've been getting behind the wheel. Waymo's been working since 2009 to make that a reality. This cute guy here is called Firefly. It's the prototype that first drove with nobody behind the wheel in 2015. This was going to be the world's first experience with cars driving around city streets with nobody behind the wheel. So we wanted people to feel comfortable. With that in mind, we made the car cute. We put a lot of effort into safety and great design. You'll also notice a lot of sensors around. That's how the car uses the sensors to figure out where it's going and how it wants to drive. But what you may not notice is what's not here. There's no steering wheel. Well, who is driving then? It's the Waymo Driver. The Waymo Driver is a set of hardware and software technologies that we've been working on since 2015. It's a combination of sensor inputs and machine learning that uses advanced algorithms to drive the car on real public roads and take you where you need to get to go. There are degrees of autonomy. The simplest version is nothing at all, and a step up from that would be cruise control. A new car you buy today would come with what we would call level 2 autonomy. That's where it will keep you in the lane and do gas and brake, but that you as a driver always need to be ready to take over at a moment's notice. That's not what we're building. Waymo is building a level 4 driver. And level 4 means that you don't have to touch the steering wheel at all. In fact, we ask that you don't. How does Waymo see the world? Through sensors. We have 4 different kinds of sensors placed all around the vehicle, up top, around the sides, to see 360 degrees around us at ranges of up to half a kilometer. We have 4 different kinds of sensors: cameras, LIDARs, radars, and external audio receivers, or ears. First, let's talk about cameras. I'm sure you're familiar with what a camera is, but why does Waymo need one? Well, there's certain information about the driving world that you can only get through color, specifically traffic lights. You need to know if they're red or green. But it's also useful to fuse that information with the other sensors and form a richer understanding of what's going on around us. Next, we have LIDAR, which you may not have heard of. LIDAR is a laser range-finding system, and it gives us a 3D view of the world. If you come to the museum, you'll be able to see what that representation looks like. It's incredibly detailed. Next, we have radars, which you've probably heard of. Why do we have them? Well, they have different strengths compared to the other sensors. In particular, they can see through dense fog and rain. They also give us a direct measurement of how fast something is going, so we can tell if someone's slowing down for a turn. Lastly, we have the microphones. Those are useful for understanding sirens, so we can respect emergency vehicles. We fuse all of that information together, form a deep understanding of the world, and that's what lets the Waymo Driver drive. And now I'll tell you about that. If you come to the museum, this section of the exhibit will show you how the Waymo Driver understands the world. You can see us responding to a red light runner in San Francisco. You can also see us navigating through a pretty complex construction site. And can you view that through the LIDAR view? You can also see it through the normal camera view. And then finally, you can see the annotated view, which shows you how the Waymo Driver understands the things around it. I took my first ride in an autonomous vehicle in 2009. We drove through a parking lot at 3 miles per hour and hit a curb. We've come a long way since then. We're now running a real service called Waymo One, serving over 50,000 trips a week across the country in Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Phoenix. In 2024, we opened our service to Angelenos. You can now download the Waymo One app from your favorite app store and join a wait list. But if you come to the Petersen Automotive Museum and check out our exhibit, you can skip the line. You can see a rich history of cars on display. Here, we have an electric car with no steering wheel and 1 seat for a driver. And here, we see an electric car with no steering wheel and every seat is for a rider. This is Waymo's sixth generation self-driving system. It's a platform built for scale to serve more cities, including those in colder climates. And it has the steering wheel removed for more seats for passengers. For over 100 years, we've thought of cars as something we should drive ourselves to get from place to place. But I want you to think about a future where you can be transported with someone else taking care of that, the Waymo driver. In 15 years, we've gone from what you saw as a cute prototype to something that's really helping people get where they need to go, and we're saving lives. I couldn't be prouder of what the team and I have been working on for these last years, and I really hope you get a chance to check it out for yourself at the museum. I'm Andrew Chatham, and thanks for watching.